And now for today's Bible question. Today we have heard how Jesus taught his disciples in parables and learned how the Word of God is like the seed that is planted in the heart and grows and produces fruit. Someone might ask the question, why do some people hear and respond to the Word of God while others do not? I believe that much of what Jesus has been teaching us in this chapter has to do with the subject of divine revelation and divine illumination. Revelation are those truths from the Word of God that God has sent forth, like the seed spread upon the ground. Illumination is how the Holy Spirit gives us an understanding of the Word of God so that it can bring forth a response of faith. People do not always receive the revelation of God with joy. Sometimes the devil snatches away the seed, or a person realizes that to accept the word means facing difficulties and persecution. Or others simply get so caught up with the affairs of this world that the word of God is not important to them. Only when a person understands by the illumination of the Holy Spirit the great treasure of life that is hidden inside the seed of God's word, then he will gladly receive it. Once the word is received by faith, the seed will produce life, grow and manifest itself, and bring forth fruit. The Bible tells us that faith comes by hearing, and hearing by the word of God. Romans chapter 10, verse 17. Many people are exposed to the word, but not all are listening to it carefully. We must realize that the Word of God is vitally important to us and listen to it attentively with a desire to learn and obey what God is revealing. We might consider an example to help us understand this point. Imagine a man who has been given his electricity bill in the mail, but he forgets about it and does not bother to pay. After some days, his lights go off, and he then remembers that he forgot to pay. It may be inconvenient to have the lights go off at home, and even a bit annoying, but it could have been prevented if he had taken time to pay attention to the bill when it came in the mail. When God sends his word to us, he expects us to pay attention to it, for if we ignore it, or think we will just look at it later, then we are in great danger of missing out on the blessing God has for us and falling under God's judgment. There are many souls in hell today that certainly did not plan to be there, but they just neglected to pay attention to God's word. We all have important things to attend to in life, but do not let anything get in the way of your listening to the word of God. It is the Word of God that leads us safely home to heaven. And if we fail to hear and respond to what God has so carefully sent to us in His Word, then we will most certainly be very sorry when we wake up in the fires of hell, where there is no escape. But then it will be much too late to try and listen to God's Word. Remember this, that God does not owe it to you or I to offer us salvation, and he does not owe it to us to keep pleading for us to listen to his voice when he speaks. He, in his grace, will continue to try to get our attention, but sooner or later he will stop and leave us to our stubborn rebellion. I hope you will listen to the voice of Jesus today and give your heart to him in faith. In the end of your life, nothing will matter more than how you responded to the call of Jesus. So then, faith comes by hearing, and hearing by the Word of God. Romans chapter 10, verse 17.